I've had a really, really good experience. I've never really gotten to do anything like this.
We are like a lobby that's family from the lab. So yeah, we are like family.
It's not all about being in the lab and do research, but it's also about making friends.
Both SUROP and REUs are designed to provide undergraduate students research experiences with a mentor who conducts research at K-State and works with our graduate students.
I got two friends in Puerto Rico. Like, they told me that SUROP program was so amazing and so cool. So I just say, okay, I will try it then. I will go myself and see if that will be the same works for me when I come back.
The intent of this program is to provide students an opportunity to experience firsthand what research is all about and the opportunities it can afford both in graduate education and as a career.
It's important to get research because then you know what you like and don't like.
I'm working in a field of math called number theory, and my specific project has to do with a type of group called finite abelian groups. And we're looking at subsets of these groups and finding an upper bound on the size of the subset.
I'm trying to look for the leaf spectral index and the plant performance of big blue stem. A big blue stem is a grass that is being used for forage grass in cattle. It's the major ecological dominant in all the Great Plains. And we are trying to look which one is better to go to restoration areas across all the gradients of the Great Plains.
The title of my project is Epitope Mapping of Protein NSM of Rafale Fever Virus. It's not here in the US, it's over in Africa, Saudi Arabia, Yemen. It's a detrimental virus to their economy because they depend mostly on livestock. And so I'm just characterizing the immune response of the protein NSM. It's a non-structural protein, and basically trying to figure out which part of the protein elicits the best autoimmune response.
We're studying aerosols, which are just suspended particles in air. When they go up in the atmosphere, most of the time they scatter light and they cool the climate by preventing a lot of the light that the sun is emitting from getting to the surface and re-radiating it back into space. But soot is different because it's black and it also absorbs the sunlight, so it heats up. And we're studying specifically to see whether soot can form what's called a glory. If you're like above the clouds and like the sun's directly behind you and you look down and you see like kind of like a halo around your shadow, then that's a glory where all the light was just scattered directly back to your eyes.
My project was just, it was analyzing grain sorghum and seeing if it was a viable feedstock. And the way my results look now, it probably is. So it could be classified as an advanced biofuel.
I'm trying to synthesize the solid acid functionalized nanoparticles that can be used for the reaction of converting cellulose to glucose for biofuels. And technically, the point of this research is we synthesize solid catalyst and with a magnetic core so that they can be easily and cheaply separated out of the reactant by using a magnet.
My project's official name is Gold Nanoparticles in Electric Fields. A nanoparticle is 10^-9, so it would be like taking your hair, like a strand of your hair, dividing it by 50 and then dividing it by like 1,000, I think. So it's really tiny. We're applying a uniform field to a drop of nanoparticles suspended in toluene and seeing how they react.
It went really well. I learned a lot. Coming into this environment, everybody was really nice and, you know, helping me out.
There are exceptional people.
Now I know people from all over the country.
It helps you get a better understanding of what you like and what you don't like, whether or not you even like research.
I think my biggest problem, I don't know if this might just be like as a woman in science, has always been confidence for me. I think my confidence has just gotten a lot better.